Cyberpunk FPS made for the Source engine, the engine of Half-Life 2. Yeah, and from what I've heard, this game was in development for a decade. So yeah, we can expect that a lot of love went into it. And this depicting what seems to be a dark cyberpunk future, similar to Blade Runner or Ghost in the Shell. From what I've heard, it plays in Korea, but we will see, I'm not sure. And yeah, it is focused on world building and storytelling. That is always a checkmark in my book. And yeah, I enjoy this genre. And yeah, let's check it out. Options, I already said everything, but to show you what you can do, it is basically then, like in most Source games. See, it's English language, okay. So expecting perhaps if it was done in a different country, you might have two languages, but that's fine. Yeah, already checked this, and yeah, you have also a post-process menu for settings. I will leave standard, but while we will play, we might check out the other presets. Soundcheck. Check out the other presets. Okay, sounds fine. Good, let's start the game. Yeah, and I will not comment everything or too much. I also want to let the game talk, stay in the focus, and in order to keep the atmosphere. I like it, a lot of interesting topics covered. AI, lack of resources, environmentalism, transhumanism, spacefaring. Sounds intriguing.
Determination.
Yeah, that was an excellent introduction. And yeah, the audio visual presentation. The audio visual presentation is outstanding. I mean, if you with the time played some source projects, you can tell the difference, of course, but this is the work that went into it alone to make this room here, this backgrounds, yeah, beautiful. And this is absolutely my favorite depiction of cyberpunk, this dark, dirty, yeah, Blade Runner style or Ghost in the Shell style. Absolutely my thing, really fantastic. Good. Yeah, looks like we are there's some sort of rebellion going on the Mars colonies. Looks like there was a hostage situation which spiraled out of control. Yeah, okay. First look at my beautiful room. Yeah, and some shady stuff was going on there in this facility. I'm not sure if this is the same facility like we are here. We were watched. We saw our own main character, it seems. Okay, let me just do another sound check. Because I had problems with OBS. Okay. Good. And looks like we have some powers. Yeah, that's right, you can grab stuff. That doesn't look natural. That looks su supernatural. Get it. C is free, right? Other hand. If you need to do the duck jumps, I guess my muscle memory will tell me to use the. I think C is more convenient to use if you need to duck often, especially if you have no toggles, but whatever, we'll see. Some sort of lab rat, as the chapter name already suggests. Mio, here all the. Jody, Starship Loader. Yeah, I think that was a quite interesting idea in Blade Runner, and also here it seems to be the introduction when this commercial ad ship flew by that I could reimagine that one day that people will have love interests in either virtual or. The guy planning.
Okay.
Hey Simon.
Pyrokinesis.
Is this game using the Source engine? Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, it is definitely based on the Source engine. I didn't get the instructions. What are we? Test läuft. Okay, what are we supposed to do? Get glass. I think there was a human being falling down, but perhaps I didn't see it correctly. I hope it wasn't. Something I have happened. God damn it.
Standard
ト異臭バイオスーツメッセージシステムイニシャティドローレベルライトエンバイロメントデテクティドリメーニングオンボードライトソースバッテリーライフ73アワーズ。
Shit, yeah, I was planning something to do. Okay, can't control it. Look at this, I think this was... I've never seen something that's done like this with the Source engine. It looks quite impressive. That is... exactly what I was looking for.
Standard issue BIOSuit message system initiated. Onboard GPS unit battery damaged. Please report to the nearest FEMA biohazard office.
Some very interesting art to be found in this project. Okay, I will make a short break here, but just to cut the video.